It's really fun to be out here in this day and age because we have so many cool technologies that we can bring to help us observe the challenging ocean ecosystems that are underwater and mostly microscopic. We're using a combination of things like high-speed underwater imaging and also acoustic sounding, as well as traditional methods like net tows to collect animals and bring them back on board the ship so we can study them in more detail.
We deploy this high-resolution imaging system called Stingray, and it captures really detailed images of the organisms and also captures the environment, so the basic parameters of where they're living. And so, for instance, just on this cruise, we've already seen a dense patch of sea butterflies or pteropods right near the surface. A lot of them are hanging out at deeper mesopelagic depths during the day and then migrating up to the surface at night. And I really find zooplankton to be this real middle box, right? So they're right smack in the middle between the primary producers, the phytoplankton, and then the forage fish and higher trophic levels. So they're this conduit between the surface layers and the deep ocean is really technologically challenging to sample, but so essential for understanding the system as a whole.
Yeah, exactly. And they're kind of in this. We're working intensively with things like machine learning and other kinds of artificial intelligence to help us make the most sense we can of these vast quantities of data we're now collecting.
I'm trying to create kind of a library of all these animals we're seeing, and so we can then use kind of sophisticated machine learning algorithms to automate some of our processing of that data. And the ultimate goal is really to define who's in the water column, where they are, and how abundant they are.